Hello, my name is Suguru Goto. First of all, thank you for the invitation, and also thank you for the, being here. I'm a composer, I'm a multimedia artist, and what I'm going to talk is the artistic work with some technology and robots. This morning, I was asking myself, I saw many intelligence and very high technology presentation this morning. I was asking, am I going to speak next, really? Or I'm just escaping from here somewhere. nothing advanced, nothing with so complex intelligence, but the, I'm trying to show my works with a video or the picture as much as possible. You have to explain some of my works. It's better to start a little bit about my background. And then I was asked many times, more than 1,000 times, why are you making the robot for the music and so on. So I briefly talk about wisdom and purpose. And then the some of my previous works, and then the sort of a development from this period, then I'm going to talk my recent works at the end. First of all, I was born in Japan and moved to Tokyo, then I studied there. My former study is really musical composition and performance. I've studied in the United States, and then I studied in Germany, in Berlin, briefly, and then I moved to France. It's where I'm living now. To define myself, I'm a new media artist who composes music and who does also the image at the same time. But the I've been working in the institution. It's called IRCAM. IRCAM is part of the Pompidou Center. They dedicate for the music and some technological development, but later years they work a lot for the interactive system, especially for the new media art. So that's what I have done for a long time there. And now I teach at Bordeaux Art University for the interactive system and the digital sound and so on. So, okay. At the beginning, I started to develop some of my musical instrument, which is called virtual musical instruments. I'm going to explain more about these works. But the reason I started to this instrument is sort of an interface for the control of robot. And this robot is intended use in the work. It's called augmented body and the virtual body. So the basic idea is that, for example, dancer has sort of the interface, such as a virtual music instrument, and they remotely control the robots. But in the context of performance, I don't develop a robot for the technological or the scientific reason. I just work with the robot based on the reason of the artistic purpose. And then net body is the extension of the work of the augmented body and the virtual body. Second, I'm going to talk also more about this, but this time I work with the powered suit. This is the suit that the dancer can wear, but it is also the robot sometimes. Okay, so before I show some of my works, the first question is, why am I making a robot for the music? There are many limitations for the human performance. It doesn't mean like physical possibility, but there are some limitation of, I would say, intellectual or psychological reason. Most of the traditional instrument player does not want to go beyond the tradition of the music. So the between composer and performer, we have always, I won't say fight, but there is some conflict with each other. And the on the other hand, there is not so many limitation. I would say not only physical limitation, but for example, robot can play very accurately. And the, as a composer, let's say if I write very complex rhythm, they never complain. They just play as it is written. And sometimes they can perform from the program, the algorithm, and so on. So the, there are many possibilities with robots. And the other thing is, can a robot make emotional music? I would say that the there are many things to answer about this, but there is a sort of special application for the music, especially nowadays. I often use Max MSP, which is developed at Uricom at the very beginning of the 80s. Then the now it's spread everywhere to be used this software. But there are many libraries and objects and so on. So the it's not only matter to generate musical data, but we have already quite a possibility to express more musical sound and very rich sound, also express music and so on. But the at the end, my art is not really based on the robots, which replacement of for the human performance. In my case, in order to develop new artistic field, I work with robots. So that is one reason. And the other one is also the to have more the sophisticated extension for the musical performance. The first one is virtual violin. As a original violinist, I perform myself at that time. It is called Superform. It is a virtual violin, but it does not mean also to imitate the violin. It's just the gesture is only imitated. So the I can perform like a violin, but what you hear is completely opposite. Opposite means that the, for example, if you know about violin, you can have one single note, or maybe sometimes two notes at the same time. But the with the sound for the computer, from the computer, I can generate notes as much as I like, for example. Or maybe I play like very expressive violin sound, but suddenly I can modify to the orchestral sound, so that the I can really play, I can really like organize this kind of a trick on the context of the performance. So that's the idea of the virtual violin, that the only gesture is interfaced, but the what you hear is completely different. The other one is motion capture system. The virtual violin is quite based on the musical instrument idea, but this time I thought that it should not be based on object. It's rather something to wear, so that the I don't have to ask always musician. I can collaborate, for example, dancer or sometimes maybe actor. They don't know anything about music, for example, but depending on the gesture, they can perform music. That's also idea. It looks like this. This is the first generation of my motion capture system. It's called bodysuit. There are sensors on each joint of the body, and the depend on the movement, one can generate sound and image. I used to have a bending sensor, but now I use EMU. EMU is a combination of the accelerometer and the gyro sensor and so on. And the one you see on the right is the next version. This time, there are many mechanical supports. So you can really measure or detect the movement precisely, but sometimes for a dancer it's quite difficult. There are many limitations of the expression of the dance and so on. But nowadays I use both of them for my theater or musical performance work with dance. This work is called Long Transcendé. So, like I said, this interface meant for the control for the detection of the movement. But at the end, I wanted use for the robot to control remotely. So the I could not start at the same time, and also it took so many years to develop. So the after the bodysuit, I gradually developed the robotic music. This is not the humanoid robot. It's just the only the some of the part of the body is imitated. For example, for the percussionist, in order to perform musical sound, they need certain gesture that only one single motor cannot be depressed. So the this kind of a gesture model, and then I try to imitate movement of the percussionist performer. So the I have now five robots: snare drum, bass drum, and cymbal, and gong, and pipe. Pipe means that the this is a little bit different from others. There are many, many pipes, and depending on the length of the pipes, you can change the pitch. And as it spins faster, it goes up the overtone series. So I will show you with video later. So this is the close picture of the bass drum robot. And this is snare drum robot. The next one is large tom-tom robot. But as long as it can play with mallets, one can replace the instruments. This is gong robot. I work with one of the Japanese robotic company. It's called Ixis Research. And also the collaboration with UCAM. And this work is shown at the Venice Biennale. One is for the interactive installation. And then I did also the concert with same robots. Interactive installation means that the, for example, public can come in the gallery. And then, for example, they can draw the picture. Means that it's sort of the score for the robot. So the public can compose, and right away robot can play as you draw the picture. So this is one of the recording during the Venice Biennale. Unfortunately, I cannot show every all the video, but you get some idea. Computer robot is controlled, and the robot also controls the light system, which is the motorized light system, so they can really synchronize with music. I can go a little further, for example. Thank you. Okay, maybe. Let's keep a little fast to show people. There was a little bit of discussion, sorry. This morning, it's really difficult to maintain robots for this stage work, but it's just, as you see, I was looking very nervous. it means that the robots were broken all the time, and I had to be I had to really repair during the one performance. I didn't have even one night. I had to really fit. I wouldn't say fix, but I had to really manage to do the next performance during 50 minutes and so on. So it was really quite a difficult performance. So the robots are ready, and the interface are ready. Now, finally, I could start my real idea. This is a dancer, and then next one is the robotic music that you saw. This dancer has never performed any musical instrument. But for example, during the theater, he can just pretend playing an instrument in the air. But he himself doesn't play any instrument, but a robot can play instead of him. So that's the idea, for example. And sometimes during the theater, he can act like a conductor of orchestra. So the depend on his gesture, there is programming behind that his gesture is analyzed and then interpreted as a musical phrase and so on. So this is the work of the augmented body and the virtual body. And then next one is really a development of the idea of the augmented body and the virtual body, but this time the second one. So again, I use for the musical theater work conjunction with a performance bodysuit and also the robotic music. I add another application, it's called Second Life. At that time, it was quite known, and there are many, many users. I think nowadays it's getting less and less. But the, I built sort of the virtual space. Oh, speaking to the Second Life, it is sort of virtual community. And you can participate in this community with your own avatar. Sometimes you can create your own avatar, and you can be very nice looking in the virtual world. Or maybe most of the people has quite similar physical appearance and avatar as well. You can construct also your own house. In my case, I built my own stage, so that the it's not for me. It's actually for the public. Public can participate the performance during this performance. For example, avatar can come one of the side, and he can transform a certain avatar, which I'm going to explain later, and the other one, and so on. So, one avatar can be transformed as soon as he appears on the stage. It means that the idea is that to connect virtual world and real world. Real world means, for example, the real performance on stage. And the public can participate also for the performance with his own avatar. So, for example, one of the possibilities is that this is a little bit small, but this is the power suit. Power suit is actually developed myself with some help of the Excess Research Corporation. There's a motor on each joint of the body. And the dancer wears this, but he does not dance his own will. It means that the robot does dance. And it's not too much to say that he's almost forced to move, to dance with this. So going back to the idea of the second life, let's say someone from Japan access this stage with his own avatar, and he comes up on this side of the stage. And let's say we have a performance here in Prague, and the dancer is here with powered suit. But idea that this person in Japan can participate the performance in Prague, so the he does sort of dance on this side, but the movement is copy in here. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. And the other idea is that the, let's say someone in Paris shows up here, and the other one is a bodysuit. So in this case, he's he participates in performance, but he does nothing on the stage. That the gesture in Prague is imitated in Paris, so that the connection of the virtual world and the real world is idea. But difficulties have to be solved on the context of performance, that it shouldn't be like a technological demonstration. It should be really artistic narrative work. So the, on the other hand, it's quite difficult to solve also artistic context. Okay, so this is close look of the powered suit, as you see this one. The one has to be careful of the, his this movement of the powered suit. It shouldn't force too much, then his bones can be broken. Oh, it's never happened, fortunately. But the we never know. It's not. I had all the limitation of the this movement physically and also in the programming too. I have some sensor for each motor, so I could also feedback in other sense. But sometimes, depending on the combination of the body, for example, I can do this easily, but if I push like this, if I try to twist, it really hurts. So sometimes I could hear that the dancer is screaming on from his helmet, but it's only happened once time, and then I changed the program once more. I have to be careful about this. These are my previous works, and then next robot is I work with trumpet robot, but it could be any kind of a brass instrument. Idea was that the to imitate artificial mouths, so that the once the parts of the like a mouth and lips and the lung imitate, one can play any kind of instrument. It doesn't have to be trumpet. At the end, it could be also possible clarinet and flute and so on. So the I work for a long time at IRCAM for this project with as a researcher and so on. The idea behind is that at the end, I wanted to construct an orchestral robot. But since it takes so much time for this robot, at this moment, it still remains to development of this artificial mouse. One can have sort of very mechanical sound from trumpet, but if I want to really express more musical sound, I need some more parameters to control quite each detail of the muscle of the lips. The music works not only one single note, but it's really there are many parameters like expression of the musical element or the dynamics or the combination of these parameters has also a lot of meaning for music. So unfortunately, I cannot read that Weber still plays very primitive musical sound. So this is the one of the robots that I've been working. And the, also the other one is, it's getting to be less robotic, but I'm now working a lot of projection mapping. Still, dancer wears motion capture systems called power suit, but the idea is not quite robotic, but in the narrative context, I ask a question, what is the human body? Or I wouldn't say it's an opponent, but the, such a mechanical body and so on. So the instead of working technical side, I rather raise a question. Doesn't mean that I stage something on stage work, but for example, this work is based on the idea of the dualism. So that the, let's see here, try to really show that the, what is the human body, and then, for example, if you see there is on stage man and the woman wears a sort of organic bodysuit, and the other one is quite mechanical, robotic suits. So the, in a way, with some conceptual idea, I've been working with the, this theme, what is a human body. So I'm gonna show some of the recording of this performance, which is recorded in Taiwan. Is it okay for the time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I cannot show everything, but I'm gonna show some of this. Okay, have to for example, the gesture of the dancer triggers image on the floor. Well, in the recording, it's a little bit hard to see, but if you use concert voice, it was easy to see. And something like this. You can find easily these words in the internet. So, time I'm going to skip like this, but I hope I can show you some other time. The last work is called Cymatics. The idea came from the during the research of the trumpet robot. One can easily ask why robot not the trumpet itself. I'm not talking about trumpet robot, but trumpet itself. Why it sounds so loud? Well, it's performed by human anyway. What you can do with your lung, the air is quite limited, but it sounds so loud. You can hear even someone plays 2 kilometers or 3 kilometers far away, but you can hear it. It works sort of the resonance frequency. There is also there is the length of the pipe. And then the there is certain frequency, it resonates with this. And then the energy goes quite harder with this. So the that's why the trumpet is quite loud. What's other case? I don't know if you see the video in YouTube. There was an earthquake in San Francisco somewhere. And then the bridge was shaking a little bit. But the frequency of the earthquake, and also each object has its own frequency, and by chance it became same, so that energy became huge, and at the end it was broken. It's something like this. And cymatics is a little bit, it's quite a similar idea. Each container has his own frequency, and I had sort of the solenoid on the bottom. And this vibration makes sort of the sound. But sometimes, if resonance becomes same, the water starts to jump. I use also as a liquid, it's called the non-Newtonium liquid. So as it also becomes same frequency, this liquid is not liquid anymore, but it starts to be like shape of the monster. I don't have much time, so I want to show video at the end. The first one is sound insulation for the liquid water. It is interactive sound insulation. So public can come in this room, and there's iPad, so he can choose different kind of a parameter. Next one is sound insulation for non-Newtonian fluid. So at the beginning, if you have just regular sound, as I said, and then it still remains like a liquid, but then frequency starts changing, you saw a little bit. Something like this. So the pitch goes down. During the exhibition, there were many children, and they saw that the liquid became like a monster, and they tried to catch it. But then, once they catch it, there is no force of sound, so it just becomes liquid again. So it's just the liquid goes on the floor. So every day we have to clean everywhere for the room of this Newtonian fluid. So this is basically end of my presentation. The development of robots extended artistic possibility for me. So the idea came from the artistic side, and then depending on the idea, I developed technological sides. So in my case, it's a little bit opposite. I don't start with abstract idea, then application. I start as an application, then try to create such a, materials for the artistic expression, means the robot. And because of this idea, the robots and the artistic concept coexist. the none of them superior or inferior, but that I just cooperate with them in order to extend my artistic work. So thank you very much.